Topic 11.4, the antiderivatives of trigonometric functions. In solving antiderivatives of trigonometric functions, we should take note of this, Theorem 13. So, mauni ang integration sa mga trigonometric functions. Yeah. Number one, integral of sine x dx is equivalent to negative cosine x plus c. Integral ni cosine x dx is equivalent to sine x plus c. Integral ni secant squared x dx is equivalent to tangent x plus c. Fourth, integral ni cosecant squared x dx is equivalent to negative cotangent x plus c. And integral ni secant x tangent x dx is equivalent to secant x plus c. And lastly, integral of cosecant x cotangent x dx is equivalent to negative cosecant x plus c. Asan ni gikan, actually, dito ra pud sa antiderivative, sa derivative na to. Diba? Let's say kani. Sa kanito, kaniman is an antiderivative ani. Meaning, pag imong i-differentiate ni, kani dapat ang labas. So, unsa ang derivative ni negative cosine x? Cosine x plus c. Sige, anaw na to. Negative cosine x plus c. Di ba? Derivative. Negative ba na siya? So, copy lang na to si negative. Unsa'y derivative ni cosine x? Di ba ang derivative ni cosine x is negative sine x? Tapos, unsa'y derivative ni constant? Zero. So, as is lang na. So, therefore, that is sine x. So, tama nga sine x mo ni. So, tama nga ang antiderivative ni sine x is negative cosine x because pag i-derivative ni mo, differentiate ni mo ni, kaniman ang result. Same goes sa uban. Dato ra ang process na kung asa to sila gitan. So let's now apply this theorem to solve antiderivatives of trigonometric functions. So we have here four examples and you are asked to the instruction is to determine the antiderivatives of the following. So number 1 kani, number 2, number 3, number 4. So ato nang isa-isahon og discuss. So ang first problem is kani, the antiderivative of cosine of the quantity cosine x minus sine x dx. So since minus ang between, this is difference of two functions. So applying the rule, we can actually separate ang kanya-kanyang function. So that becomes equivalent to integral of cosine x dx minus integral of sine x dx. Then isa-isahon na lang na to integrate. Integrating this one, we use katong theorem na to. Unsa integral ni cosine? So, nara si cosine. Integral ni cosine is sine x plus c. So, sine x. Manang sine x niya. Ang plus c, sa last part na lang na nyo may butang. Next, so mana. Minus. Nara. Happy lang na si minus. Kanina po. Unsa ang integral ni sine x, balik na po ka dito sa inuhang theorem. Integral ni sine x is negative cosine x. So, negative cosine x nara. So, then, negative cosine x, then dito na ka magbutang og plus c sa last. So, next, since natay minus negative, again, we minus og negative man eh. So, before we solve, we have to change operation and change sign ni dere. So, moto na sine x plus cosine x plus c na siya. So this is now your final answer. So nato lang kasimple mag pangitag antiderivative sa trigonometric functions. So basically, kailangan lang gid nimo ma-familiarize ang theorem 13. So kani. Okay, next example. Okay, actually ang given ani is kanilang integral of cotangent x a cotangent squared x dx. So, based sa given, kung wanto ta sa tong theorem, wala tayo makitang cotangent squared dere. Walay cotangent squared dere. So, naa cosecant squared, naa secant squared, pero wala tayo cotangent squared. So, dili ta makadirectly og solve ato. Instead, amuhat na nato, we recall the identities. So, recall sa atong pre-calculus na kaninga identities. Actually, this is a trigonometric identity. So, ang cotangent actually sa identity is equivalent to cosecant squared x ni dapat diha minus 1. So, giusab na to, nahimo na siya karong, ang cotangent squared, nahimo na siya cosecant squared x minus 1. So, again, unsay purpose na to? Because wala tay, wala sa theorem na nakahat na ay cotangent x, a cotangent squared x. So, mao to, gigamitan na to siya og identity. E para, si cosecant squared naa naman. Kung tanaw na to, balikan na to, oh, naa naman tay cosecant squared. So, pwede na nato ma-integrate. Pero kung cotangent squared, wala man. No, itong i-change siya. So, nanatakaroy yung ani. So, na minus 1 sa tunga. So, pwede na nato bulagon kada isa. Integral ni cosecant squared x o integral ni ang 1, pwede na mawala. Kaya na may dx diha. Actually, na ay 1 diha. Wala lang disulat. So, isa-isa ho na karon og solve. Kung sa integral ani, to refer na pong kasemong antiderivative, so which is negative cotangent. So, ang tag negative cotangent squared x. Kumuntoy, nakabutang. Negative cotangent, ano, sorry. Negative cotangent lang diyan, sorry. Negative cotangent lang. So, mali ni ang answer dari. So, dapat, mali ni, so dapat ang answer ani is negative cotangent x. Then, minus, kanina po, integral of dx and rule number 1 na, actually, nga integral of dx is x. Tapos, sa final answer na kama, plus c. So, this is actually the correct answer. So, please take note sa book ni, na there's something wrong aning answer. So, correct answer is negative cotangent x minus x plus c. So that's the answer sa kaninga problem. Okay. Next, we have integral of tangent squared v dv. So again, kung tanaw na to ang kuan, ang theorem 13, wala tay makit ang tangent squared. Naalang cosecant squared o secant squared. So, kailangan nato ni gamitan og trigonometric identity. And kailangan ka mo tanaw mo recall sa imong pre-calculus. Tanaw to ni mo mga identities. Unsay pwede magamit ng identity nga si tangent? Anta ni atong magamit? Tangent squared v is equivalent to secant squared v minus 1. So, mao to, ang kaning integral ni tangent squared v dv is just equivalent to integral of the quantity secant squared v minus 1 dv. Then similarly, minus, so pwede rin nato isa-isahon sila. Then isa-isahon natong integrate. So integral ani. So ato nakakaroon kay theorem secant squared. So sa secant squared, naa na secant squared, which is ang answer is tangent x. So, yun. Nana tayo tangent x kung secant squared x. Pero secant squared v man eh. Kaya na tangent v. And then, minus v. Kaya integral ni dv. Following integral of dx is equivalent to x. So, integral of dv is equivalent to v. And again, don't forget your plus c. So, your final answer is tangent v minus v plus C. So that's another example. Last example. We have here integral of sine x over cosine squared x dx. So again, wala tay division rule sa integration. Dili, wala di ka gagamit atong low d high minus high d low kay pang differentiation naman to. Sa integration, ang buhato nimo i-simplify yun nimo siya. So saan nimo pag simplify aning sine x over cosine squared x? One way to do that is kaning si cosine squared imong isa bulagon. Kaya si cosine squared man is just cosine x. Cosine squared x is just equivalent to cosine x times cosine x. Kaya cosine x times cosine x, cosine squared x man. So, ang say purpose na gibulag niya kay para kaning si sine x over cosine x using quotient identity nato sa una is just equivalent to tangent x. And then, kaning 1 over cosine x, recall that it is equivalent to second x using katong reciprocal identity po. So, mao ni karon. So, ang problema ana karon kung nalimtan niyo na ninyong mga identity. So, kung nalimtan na ninyong identity, kailangan ninyo to i-recall kay gamiton to sa kaninga topic. So, kato yung mga identities. So, again, nganong na tangent ni tungod ani? Equivalent man na siya. Si sine x over cosine x, equivalent raman na kay tangent x. And kaning si second x, equivalent po na kay 1 over cosine x. So, next, nganong giingani ni kay because sa kani garon, pwede na nato magamit si theorem. Kay naaman na si integral of second x tangent x. Second x man na. So, mao to, ang answer niya is second x. Then, again, don't forget your plus c. So, that's how to solve anti-differentiation or integrals involving trigonometric functions. So, basic lang yung mga examples. Naapay mga solve examples sa inyong book na para ma-studyhan ninyo, para mas masabtan pa. And again, ang pinakatambal yun, ana, is mag-practice. So, that's all sa anti-derivatives of trigonometric functions. Thank you and see you next session.